In today's video, I'm going to create some really cool VFX on the go with this laptop. All right, so here is the deal. We're going to try and levitate myself in the forest. So we need two things. We need a clean plate, so we are going to record our environment separately from myself. And then in the same environment, we're going to set up a portable green screen and record myself against that green screen in two times. Once it's going to be the animation of my top body, and once it's going to be the animation of my feet levitating from the ground and hovering in midair. So let's get started. Right, now comes the moment that we're going to record with the green screen, so... Or we can actually choose, green or blue? What do we go for? Maybe blue. We are going blue screen. Ah, no. And I'm also wearing green. It's gonna be fun. All right, so we have another challenge to see. We're gonna get this one solved, but... Whoa! Oh, that's a pretty big green screen. Okay, I cannot do this alone. Please help. So now we have recorded our three different shots and we need to paste them together in Adobe After Effects. And I chose for being in a different environment, staying outdoors, because this laptop allows me to do that. I'm going to be using the Acer Concept D laptop. All right, so let's get started. I can actually work outdoors with this laptop due to the quality of the screen. It's really amazing and bright enough to work outdoors right here. All right, so the first shot that I'm going to be using is this intro shot, which is shot with the gimbal. And all I want to do here is put myself here in the center and start floating. So I'm going to drag this into a new composition. And the first thing that I want to do here is track my footage. So I'm going over to the track tab, tracker, track camera, and then go into the advanced and just check detailed analysis. I'm not sure if you can hear the birds through my microphone, but it's actually rather nice to work outside for a change. While we're waiting for this track to be done, we're going to start keying myself out of my green screen. So the first shot that I want to work on is the Ineos off-ground shot, which I'm going to also bring into a new composition. And so right here you can see that I have two buddies of mine, Enzoe and Arnaud. The reason why we've done that is to get this realistic feeling of lifting off the ground and also have my leg animation to look as realistic as possible. So what I will do is I will choose to go over to effects and presets and search Mocha AE. I'm going to drag this onto my footage and open up Mocha. So now I want to key out my green screen, mask it a little bit around myself to make sure that I don't have Enzoe or Arnaud in my shot. And what you can do is actually transform this laptop. So let's go and do that. We can bring this out and now we can do some nice rotoscoping just like that. And that just makes the process a whole lot easier. So let's do that. All right, so what I will do here is I will mask around my pants. I just want to keep everything in here. Just like that. And actually, I'm just going to cut out at the green screen itself. Okay, so we have this mask and now I want to make sure that this mask will always stay in position so that my legs stay in this mask. So I'm just going to double check and scrub through my timeline. We can see the knee entering here. So I'm just going to create a new keyframe, tug this in a little bit. There we go. And then we're going to keep searching. Right here, I go up so we can bring this up as well. We don't really have to care about the top part because I tucked my shirt in my pants. And in the other video, we have my shirt out of my pants so we can then mask it out on top of it to make everything blend together nicely. So probably right here, I'm going to cut it off because Arnaud is getting too close to me. I have all these insects getting on top of me. I think we're almost there. So this is going to be obsolete. We don't need this mask to do any tracking. So we're also going to turn off the tracker. Now we're going to click on the X-spline again. And this time I want to zoom in. So I'm going to hold Z and then drag in here so I can really see my legs pretty close to the camera. And then I'm going to start clicking here. So I'm just going to be rotoscoping the bottom part of my feet because they're exceeding the green screen here. This is something you wouldn't need to do if your green screen would actually cover your feet. I just wanted to have the real interaction with the ground. We can right click to deselect and then tuck them in. I'm also going to start on the second foot and then we are going to track them separately. So I'm going to do this pretty roughly for now, but obviously the more time you spend on the rotoscoping part and the keying part, the better your results will be. So once you have some, I'm going to just rename this shoe one and this shoe two. Then we're going to check the gear for the shoe two and also just make it invisible so we know exactly what we're working with. And I'm going to start tracking backwards because I started my mask right here. So I'm just going to track it backwards, and all I want to do is this mask to stay in position and just rotoscope my foot. So I need to adjust it wherever I see the track going off track. And in the meantime, enjoy nature. It's pretty beautiful over here. All right, so now it's tracking in Mocha AE, and this is going to take a little while, but it's already going a lot faster than with any other conventional laptop that I have used before. This is due to the processor, which is optimized for production. Especially After Effects requires a lot of processing, and this processor makes After Effects flying fast. And comparing it to a desktop computer, it doesn't have to underperform. It also comes with a Quadro RTX 4000 graphics card, which is also an industry standards graphics card, which is very known to be very reliable. So when you're working on heavier scenes, you can expect less crashes and more stable workflows. And also everything is going to go a lot faster than this GPU based. It also comes with 32 gigabytes of RAM. So all in all, this is an incredible versatile laptop that allows you to do a lot of things.
Geen probleem hoor. Nee. Het is natuur, hè? Dat hoort er allemaal bij.
So now this is what I have left. I have my shoe one, which is tracked. And I obviously only tracked it until it covers the green screen, because there we can just key it out. I just wanted to have a mask when it goes from the ground to the green screen. Same for this shoe. And then we also have this other mask where I'm not exceeding. So now we need one more thing, and that's going to be the information of the position of my pants. So I'm actually going up in the air, and I want this information to be stored in a tracking data, so I can then put my upper body back onto these legs and then position them wherever I want and have my body actually follow that track. To just show you what I mean, is go again to the X-Spline tool, and I'm just going to track my belt, and I'm going to make sure that I don't have any other gear icon, and I'm just going to hit track forward. Okay, so if you look over there, you can see this squirrel. Yeah, that's pretty cool, right? But if you look over there, you can see a lion. And there we have a giraffe. Man, you even have penguins here. Okay, just kidding. We only see the squirrel. And I'm going to just rename this belt. So now we have four different layers. One is going to be the roto of my shoe one and shoe two. Now we have the mask around my legs, and we have the tracked information of the belt. Here we're going to leave the gear icon turned on, and for the other ones, we're going to turn it off. And now we're going to just close Mocha AE and save all the changes. Now what I want to do is go over to the mat and click on the button create AE masks. So now we are creating a bunch of masks for this, and we can immediately see that we have keyed out the first mask, which is really useful, that we have the shoes first. Then we have the other obsolete mask, which is actually taking ourselves, and the belt we can even delete it. We don't need it. So we just want this information here. And then I'm going to right click and create a new null object, and I'm going to call this belt. And so right here, I'm going to add this track data. I'm going to just make sure that I'm at the beginning of my timeline, and then open up the tracked data for Mocha. And I'm going to create track data for the belt, click OK. And then I'm going to change or export the transform to the belt layer, and then click apply. And there we should have it. So now this null should follow my belt at all times. So that's great. I'm also going to press S on the keyboard and just make sure that I turn this off. I do not want to track my scale, and neither do I want to track, well, we can leave the rotation on for now. And so that's all we need. So we have our footage and the tracked belt. Now we can start working on the second shot, which is me standing here on a log. And again, I opened Mocha AE for this shot. And all I did here is the same process. So first I have this mask around my upper body. And what I try to do here is have these lower points stick exactly to my t-shirt. And you can see that I've really went through this and took my time to roto this around the animation of my jacket. And then for my zipper right here, I just tracked that separately because that was a little bit more useful with another layer. So I just concentrated on the rough silhouette of my clothes, and then I just added back the details. And actually this one, we don't need it, so I'm going to delete it or just make it invisible. So we just need these two layers. So basically what I'm doing here is using Mocha to do masking, but I find this to be working a lot better. So I'm going to close this and save all the changes. And then right here, again, go into Create AE Masks. That's going to give me something like this. And now what I want to do is start keying the green screen. And in the meantime, we have kids playing around here. So yeah, you do get disturbed a little bit while you're editing outdoor, but it's also good to meet some people, get like different ideas. Sometimes they can come over here and share some inspiration, you know? Kids have great inspiration and great imagination. So I'm going over to Effects Keying, and I'm going to add the key light 1.2 and choose or sample my green color. Then I'm going to change the view to screen matte, and I'm going to play with the screen matte here to get my desired result. Then I'm going to set it to intermediate result, and I'm also going over to effect again, keying, and if you want, you can use the advanced spill suppressor. Now I'm going to use these key light and advanced spill suppressor, copy this and paste it right here onto my legs. So right here, you can see that I do need to have a little bit more adjustment. So I'm going to turn off the advanced spill suppressor for now and reset my key light and sample a new color to make sure that I'm working with the right color. And actually, I do see my mistake now. It was actually working well, but the mask color here is green. So I thought it was spill of my mask, but it's actually the mask. So we're good to go. All right. So now what I want to do is bring my shot here of myself on my top body. And what I want to do here is go to my anchor or pan behind tool and click on the anchor point and just put it somewhere around the belt area. Then I'm going to click on this layer, hold Ctrl, press C to copy or go to edit, copy. Go to your original footage and paste it in this clip. Now all we need to do is press V on the keyboard to have our selection tool and try to match it accordingly. So I'm going to zoom in here. Maybe we need to make it a little bit bigger, maybe a little bit smaller, and just drag it over the belt. There we have it. Now we're going to just parent this to the belt, and I'm going to select all the layers, hold Ctrl Shift C, move all the attributes, and this is going to be my body combined. So now we should have something like this. And it really looks like I'm taking off here. I do tilt a little bit to the right, so you could potentially bring this anchor point to the center area and then just counter animate it if you don't like that, because one was bigger than the other when taking me up and I do lean a little bit to the other side. So what I will do is just bring one animation, keyframe here, and then when I find myself leaning a little bit too much, just counter animate this like this. And all you can do now is select both of these keyframes, right click keyframe assistance, easy ease. All right. So now let's go back to our intro shot that we have tracked. So in this shot, I'm going to bring in Inya's off ground composition, which we just combined. And then I'm going to click on the footage that we've tracked, and I will go over here to the 3D camera tracker and choose a position I want to be in. So somewhere around here, then right click and create a null end camera. So this is going to be my 3D position. I'm going to press P on the keyboard for the null and then copy its position info. Go to my new composition here and turn this into a 3D layer, and then press the paste the composition or the position of null to this layer. Now we're going to drag this up and we're just going to eyeball the scale. Ideally, you would have been in the shot for a little while and then walk out of the shot so you have a better understanding on how big you appear in that shot. We didn't have that, so I had to eyeball it. I think something around this should work. So let's add a curves to darken my background a little bit and to match it better to me. So something like this. And then we want to find a location where I'm kind of opening my arms, like all the energy is coming through. I'm going to press P on the keyboard for this composition, and I will move forward quite a bit because I really want this to be slowly and powerful. So right here, and I'm going to then just shift myself up a little bit or just position this. Position it up wherever you want. So this is completely up to you. And now we can select both of these keyframes, right click and easy ease. So now we have myself levitating. Ooh. That was smooth, right? And there we have this creature. All right, and there we have it. So our levitation effect looks pretty great. Obviously, to fine tune it a little bit, what I've added is some screen shake, which we have done with the free screen shake preset with a link in the description. You can download that as well. You can also glow your eyes a little bit by using Mocha to track your eyes and then add the perfect glow, which is also for free with the link in the description. And then I added the leaves that are actually floating. All I have done here is masked my leaves out a little bit on the floor. So whatever leaves you see in the shot, I've masked some of them out, just three to be exact. And then in my main composition, I created a new solid with Particle Whirl on top of that and imported those leaves as a texture for my particle. And I've just reversed the gravity. So instead of falling down, they went up. All right, and that brings us to the absolute final result. Enjoy. That's it. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, give this video a like and also be sure to subscribe to the channel for more. And also I'm going to leave you with another upload of mine so you can continue your VFX journey. And I'll see you in the next one. Until then, create epic videos.